begin our journey by training these bots to walk. But how exactly does one bring a metallic corpse to life? Well, it's your friendly neighborhood, neural networks. Just like our brains, a neural network needs sensory inputs, and after some processing, we get outputs. For our quadrupedal tier, we're gonna use two neural networks. One for locomotion, helping the agent to walk and run, and the other for supervision, helping the AI strategize during warfare. For locomotion, we're gonna feed the neural network basic parameters like the agent's world position, orientation, and precise information relating to all of its limbs. Every episode, we're gonna select a random direction for the AI to follow. Not only that, we will also randomize the target velocity. The terrain will start off flat and later changed to a more curvy one. This will expose the AI to a variety of situations and train a robust walking model. Fellow comrades, let's get to training. While this AI bot is in a simulation, there are real bots and hackers online ready to steal your information. To protect your privacy, NordVPN is an excellent cybersecurity tool. Using public Wi-Fi? Well, you are handing your digital footprints to unauthorized observers on a silver platter. NordVPN protects you by concealing your personal data. With the click of a button, you can connect to secure servers around the world, all while enjoying the plethora of benefits under Threat Protection Pro. Your favorite website or service might be geo-blocked, and NordVPN removes this censorship. Within just a few clicks, NordVPN changes your virtual location, allowing you to surf the internet with no restrictions whatsoever. Their threat protection runs in the background automatically, scanning all your downloaded files from malware. Visit nordvpn.com/cosmos and get an exclusive deal with 4 bonus months on top. There is also a 30-day money-back guarantee. Once again, it's nordvpn.com/cosmos. Thanks to NordVPN, today's video partner. Our locomotion model has successfully trained. It's now time to move on to our second phase. This is a dynamic shooting range. The dummies are simulated soldiers, which can shoot back at the AI. To train our supervisor model, we will feed the neural network a pixel grid as an observation. This is an aerial view of the agent's environment, providing it necessary information like health and proximity of both hostile and friendly entities. The supervisor AI gets to control the look and walk direction of our quadrupedal, basically a steering wheel. The reward function here is extremely delicate. The AI is rewarded for maintaining high speed. This reward factor decreases over time, and the only way to reset it is by landing a bullet on the enemy, which itself also yields a +1 reward. This encourages the agent to actively hunt for targets. Folks, the firing mechanism here is automated. If the dummy enters the AI's activation cone, bullets are fired automatically. Not giving the trigger to the AI is a deliberate decision, so it can focus more on navigation and teamwork. To promote teamwork, if a dummy dies, we reward all the agents in the vicinity. However, if an agent dies, they're all penalized. This promotes strategic behavior like coordinated attacks, while discouraging clustering or friendly fire. Ladies and gentlemen, see you in the shooting range. So the agent starts off by simply wandering around. No different than a young child trying to control the steering wheel of a car. Right here, the agent gets shot into oblivion. These folks are clumping together and receiving a generous minus one reward. Now, this is after about 9 million steps. The agent is showing some competency in terms of shooting. However, it's still young and has a long way to go. Right here, you can even see the agent pulling off some Australian dance moves. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is the agent after 100 million steps. The agent is actively hunting for targets, one after the other. The agent is shooting its shots, just like my uncle. Is here. We're now gonna pit the AI against another AI. This AI dog has been trained previously on this channel using similar methods as our AI spiders. One brain for locomotion and another for supervision. I ran the training for over 2,400 simulated hours or 100 days. Initially, supervisor puppets were used for simulating warfare. This is the AI without the locomotion brain. We do this to speed up training, and once the AI shows significant progress, we replace the puppets with the original agents. It's now time to share the results. Enjoy. Well, looks like the dogs win for now. I was on Team Spiders even while coding this simulation. This is because they are way more agile in comparison to the dogs. You know how they say you can toss a coin 10 times and land tails in all of them? But the same coin tossed a million times will show a distribution of 50-50, a closer reflection of reality. Ladies and gentlemen, in order to know the true winner, we have to increase the army size. The agility of the spiders worked for them. However, the dogs are not so innocent. They do have a trick up their sleeves.
Once again.